3-minute show.
Hello there. Welcome to your favorite show. I am Mayan and this is 3-minute. Today, we have a special guest. She is here to advocate the 14 psychological principles, and here is the challenge. She must do it in a certain amount of time. The allotment is 3 minutes. Are you guys ready? Great. Without further ado, let us welcome Miss Mayan Nabihara. A round of applause, please. Hello and greetings to all. I am Mayan Nabihara from BSN Social Studies, and I am here to say that I support the 14 learning principles and their applications. The learner is the central focus of instruction. As aspiring educators, we must use these 14 learner-centered principles in order to make our teaching technique effective, and our students will benefit greatly from our efforts. The LCP were put together by American Psychological Association. Education is one of many intricate living systems that serve to meet specific human requirements. Some systems are inherently unpredictable, yet they may be understood in terms of human needs, cognitive and motivational processes, development, and individual differences. As a result, I fully support the application of 14 psychological principles. These principles are applicable to both student and learning process. The 14 principles are divided into those referring to: first, cognitive and metacognitive; second, motivational and affective; third, developmental and social; and fourth, individual difference factors. I'll just go over with the two of the 14 psychological principles and explain them to you. The first one is nature of the learning process. The learning of the complex subject matter is most effective when it is an intentional process of constructing from information and experience. There are different types of learning process, for example, habit formation in motor learning and learning that involves the generation of knowledge or cognitive skills and learning strategy. Learning in schools emphasizes the use of intentional processes that students can use to construct meaning from information, experiences, and their own thoughts and beliefs. Successful learners are active, goal-directed, self-regulating, and assume personal responsibility for contributing to their own learning. The second one is context of learning. Learning is influenced by environmental factors including culture, technology, and instructional practices. Learning does not occur in a vacuum. Teachers play a major interactive role with both the learner and the learning development. Cultural or group influences on students can impact many educationally relevant variables such as motivation, orientation towards learning, and ways of learning. Since we only have 3 minutes, you may look for additional information about 14 psychological principles on the internet. These principles are designed to apply to all learners in our educational system, including children, teachers, administrators, parents, and community members. That's all. Thank you. Thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in to Miss Mayan. Thank you so much for guesting. Have a great day and see you again next time. Bye.